The Cavapoo versus Cockapoo. How are you going to decide? If these two remarkably similar mixed breeds are your final choices for a new pet, it is understandable that you might have a hard time making a decision. After all, both breeds are descendants of the poodle, which causes them both to be very similar. Luckily, we're here to help you decide. This video is about Cavapoo versus Cockapoo, poodle mixed breeds companion. Number 8. Cavapoo versus Cockapoo genetics. The first notable difference lies in each breed's genetics. A Cavapoo is a crossbreed between a poodle and a Cavalier King Charles Spaniel. This type of dog is usually considered to have originated in Australia and has become a common breed in that country since its inception. A Cockapoo is a crossbreed between a poodle and a Cocker Spaniel. The particular type of Cocker Spaniel does not matter. The result will be a Cockapoo. As you can see, both of these crossbreeds are descended from slightly different dogs, which has a significant effect on their temperament, health, and appearance. Number 7. Cavapoo versus Cockapoo size. Because they have different parents, a Cavapoo and a Cockapoo are different sizes. A Cavapoo can weigh anywhere from 11 to 22 pounds and can reach from 11 to 17 inches tall. The exact measurements depend a lot on what type of poodle the Cavapoo is descended from. Those that were bred from a toy poodle will be smaller than those bred from mini poodles. If you're looking for a larger or smaller Cavapoo, it is a good idea to check and see exactly what type of poodle the parent is. Of course, because this is a crossbreed, a Cavapoo's exact height and weight can be extremely difficult to pin down. There is no telling which traits a Cavapoo inherited from which parent, so any prediction is just a guess. On the other hand, a Cockapoo usually reaches between 10 to 15 inches tall and weighs anywhere from 12 to 24 pounds. This differs slightly from the Cavapoo, but such a small amount can be a huge difference when it comes to these smaller dogs. Similarly to a Cavapoo, the Cockapoo's size will depend a lot on the type of poodle his or her parent is. If you want a smaller or larger Cockapoo, investigate the breeding pair before committing to a puppy. Number 6. Coat. The Cocker Spaniel and the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel have very similar coats. So both the Cockapoo and the Cavapoo can either end up with a curly coat like the poodle, or more of a straight wavy coat like a Cocker or a Cavalier. The Cavapoo and Cockapoo are both considered low shedding and might be considered hypoallergenic by some. But besides that, it becomes tough to compare them. Both dog crossbreeds vary widely in appearance because they are not purebred. It is hard to predict what they'll look like because you don't know what genes they'll inherit from what parents. Both crossbreeds can be hypoallergenic depending on which coat they inherit. If it has more of a poodle coat, then the puppy could be suitable for people allergic to dogs. Alternatively, if the coat is more straight and wavy, then the puppy will not be hypoallergenic. The coats of both the Cavapoo and the Cockapoo come in a variety of colors. They can be brown, white, black, tricolor, red, beige, apricot, chocolate, black and white, sable, and merle. Number 5. Grooming. Regarding grooming, these breeds differ widely. The Cavapoo is usually considered low maintenance. Many are cut to keep their coats short, in which case they will only require the occasional bath. If a longer coat is preferred, a weekly brushing is required to prevent tangles from forming. On the other hand, the Cockapoo's coat grows very quickly. It requires both frequent clipping and brushing to keep the coat from becoming tangled. If a Cockapoo's coat is more similar to a Cocker Spaniel than a poodle, frequent bathing will be required to keep the long, silky coat clean. Number 4. Temperament. This is where things get interesting. Cavapoos tend to be more chilled and laid back than Cockapoos. Both breeds can be brimming with energy and get the zoomies. However, in general, Cavapoos are typically found to be more chilled or quiet than the Cockapoo breed. A good walk once a day is sufficient for them. They make great family dogs as they love small children. Cavapoos create strong bonds with their humans and get very attached to their person. They are loving and gentle dogs that love to cuddle. They can be finicky eaters, and some owners struggle to find the right food for them. Cockapoos have never-ending energy and needs lots of walks and playtime. They can be a little crazy. They also tend to be very needy, and they want to be with you all the time, often having separation anxiety issues. They tend to be more vocal than the Cavapoo, but are just as loving and endearing. They are more suited to an active family that enjoys outdoor activities where their Cockapoo can join in as well. Cockapoos are also great with children and make fantastic family pets. Generally speaking, Cavapoos are considered to be gentle and loving dogs. They usually get along well with smaller children due to their taller height and are regarded as great family pets. They love the company of humans and can get very attached to their companions. As puppies, they do not react to training very well due to their short attention span, but this becomes easier as they get older. Cockapoos are considered friendly like the Cavapoo, but are affected more by separation anxiety. They don't do well home alone. They are also more active and require more exercise than a Cavapoo. However, this can make them better suited to owners with a more active lifestyle. Number 3. Health issues. Due to high bred vigor, both of these breeds are generally healthy. Cockapoos usually live longer than Cavapoos. They typically live to be around 14 to 18 years, while a Cavapoo usually only lives 13 to 15 years. Both the Cavapoo and the Cockapoo are not usually prone to many health problems, though eye problems have popped up in both breeds. Both the Cavapoo and the Cockapoo are crossbreeds, with one parent being a poodle. Poodles are generally quite healthy dogs. The main health concerns lies with the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel and the Cocker Spaniel. Both these breeds have health issues that you need to be aware of. The Cavalier King Charles Spaniel breed suffers from heart mitral valve disease, MVD, a devastating disease that claims many cavies' lives. A Cavapoo can inherit this disease, but the risk can be greatly minimized by making sure that you only buy your Cavapoo puppy from a reputable breeder that does all the necessary health checks. The Cocker Spaniel also has a few health issues, with familial nephropathy being one of the more serious diseases which affects the kidneys. They can also suffer from eye problems as well. The risks are the same as with the Cavapoo. Buying from the right breeder is crucial. Number 2. Both breeds have one training quirk. A common struggle for Cavapoos and Cockapoo owners is that they may not respond well to training at an early age. It can be frustrating when your puppy always seems to be distracted. Many owners report that as puppies, their Cockapoos and Cavapoos have a short attention span. Treats and patience will overcome this. If ease of training is your number one characteristic when selecting a dog breed, you might want to steer clear of both Cavapoos and Cockapoos. There is no significant difference in the ability to be trained between the two. Although they have their moments, compared to the Cockapoo, Cavapoos is a little laid back and does not have the same level of overly vibrant energy. They are not necessarily a low-energy dog, but as a general companion, your Cavapoo will be less of an energy powerhouse than a similarly sized Cockapoo. Four lots of Cavapoos, one walk or 20 to 30 minutes of active play in a day is adequate for them. They easily create bonds between kids and get very close to their families. Kids can tire out a Cavapoo to the point where some owners report their dog simply doesn't need walks. They are ready to snooze at any opportunity. Cavapoos are short in stature and often bond well with smaller kids. They are gentle and typically love cuddling. Number 1. Lifespan comparison between Cockapoos and Cavapoos. When buying a dog pet, many choose a breed that has a high lifespan. Like all living creatures, dogs too have a finite lifespan, depending on the kind of breed. The parent breeds of both the cockapoo and cavapoo are known for their longevity. A cavapoo has a long lifespan of 10 to 16 years. However, various factors influence how long they'll live. One of the elements is diet, genetic health, and the general care you provide your cavapoo. If the dog's parents had health problems, the puppy is likely to inherit those conditions, thus reducing its lifespan. On the other hand, a cockapoo has a long lifespan too. Small breeds tend to live for many years. A cockapoo is estimated to live between 12 and 18 years. However, just like cavapoos, their life expectancy is dependent on many factors. If you're looking for an energetic dog that can carry on for hours on end, then a cockapoo is a great choice. However, if you would appreciate a more placid dog that needs less exercise and is more of a cuddle bunny, then the cavapoo is the way to go. I highly recommend these toys, whether you decide to get a cavapoo or a cockapoo, as they are suitable for both crossbreeds. Ultimately, the choice is yours. Let us know in the comment. We'd love to hear which you chose and why. Please subscribe to The Amazing Dogs. Thanks for watching.